Let's draw the Lewis structure for C2H6. This is called ethane. The first thing we do with Lewis structures, like this one for ethane, we count the total number of valence electrons. The periodic table, that can be helpful. So here's the periodic table, and we find carbon right here. Carbon's in group 14, sometimes called 4A. So carbon has 4 valence electrons. We have 2 carbons, plus hydrogen right here, that's in group 1. All of these have 1 valence electron, so 1 times the 6. That gives us 8 plus 6, 14 total valence electrons for the C2H6 Lewis structure. So we put the least electronegative atom in the center, but hydrogen, that always goes on the outside. So let's put the 2 carbons surrounded by 6 hydrogens, like this. Next, we'll put a pair of electrons between atoms, and that's going to form the chemical bond. So we'll put a pair of electrons between each carbon and hydrogen here. So at this point, each hydrogen has 2 valence electrons. So that's good for hydrogen. It only needs 2. Each carbon has 8. And if you count all the electrons, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, we've used 14 valence electrons. So this is the Lewis structure for C2H6. You could also write it like this, where each pair of electrons is represented by a line to show that covalent bond. If you wanted to look at the molecular geometry, that would look like this. So with respect to each carbon, we have a tetrahedral molecular geometry. If you need help with that, there's a link at the end of this video for the molecular geometry for C2H6 and the bond angles. But this is the Lewis structure for C2H6 ethane. And this is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.